Since their creation by His Majesty late King Hassan II, respectively, in 1971 and 1993, the Hassan II Golf Trophy and the Lala Merriam Golf Cup continue to improve at the international level. Thanks to their unique mixed format, both events became now on synonymous of prestige. By creating the Hassan II Golf Trophy Association in 2002 and by handling its presidency to His Royal Highness Prince Mulay Rashid, His Majesty the King Mohammed VI wanted to reach a new stage in the Moroccan golf development. In 2010, the Hassan II Golf Trophy and the Lala Merriam Golf Cup became part of the European Tour and the Ladies European Tour. Throughout all these years, both events attracted the finest golf players, such as Billy Casper, Lee Trevino, Gary Player, Severiano Ballesteros, Payne Stewart, Nick Price, Vijay Singh, Sam Torrance, Colin Montgomery, Patrick Harrington, Ernie Els, and more recently, Mateo Manassaro, John Daly, and Jose Maria Olazabal. In the category of ladies golfers, Marie-Laura Delarensi, Laura Davies, Annika Sorenstam, Karen Lunn, Gladys Nocera, Patricia Mounier-Labouc, Sophie Gustafson, Cheyenne Woods, and also Charlie Hull. In 2011, for the first time in its history, the Hassan II Golf Trophy leaves Royal Golf Dar es Salaam in Rabat. Destination? Agadir. For 5 years, the finest golfers from around the globe are hosted by the magical city of Agadir. Continuity, improvement, and success. Three traditional secrets of the Hassan II Golf Trophy's accomplishment at the international stage. Thanks to media, the competition reaches now more than 750 million people worldwide and ensures an exceptional promotion for the kingdom. Thanks to the large media coverage of the Hassan II Golf Trophy and the Lala Merriam Golf Cup. The Hassan II Golf Trophy, 500 million homes. The Lala Merriam Golf Cup, 250 million homes. In a wonderful environment, Golf du Palais Royal will host for 5 years in the greatest championships. Players will remember all their life this unique and exclusive course. Their performances showed that both tournaments taking place in Agadir are far from being basic competitions.
Yeah, it's a hidden gem. It's just absolutely gorgeous.
It's a great course. It's tricky. It can get a bit windy at times.
The best conditions we play all year.
You got to play to understand what it is. It's a lovely course and probably one of the top three in the year.
The Golf de l'Océan knew the success of Charlie Hull in 2014. Who became a leader of the Ladies European Tour at only 18 years old. After 5 years on the beautiful courses of Agadir, courses requiring a tactical thinking, 5 years that shows the dynamism and the will of Morocco to stay for a long time, a key actor of the golf world, 5 years of performance, 5 years of passion and excellence. In 2016, the Hassan II Golf Trophy and the Lala Merriam Golf Cup will be back in their original lands, the birthplace of Moroccan golf, the Royal Golf of Dar es Salaam in Rabat.
Thank you.
Golf was born in Morocco more than a century ago, with the creation of the Royal Country Club of Tangier in 1914. Today, ninth world golf destination, the Kingdom of Morocco welcomes every year 100,000 amateurs, among whom famous world figures related to business world, sports, politics, and culture. Soon in 2020, Morocco will include 45 courses, most of them designed by the biggest international golf architects, such as Robert Trent Jones, Gary Player, Colin Montgomery, or Jack Nicklaus.
People are going to come to Morocco because of its weather. So if we can produce good golf facilities, the friendliness of the country of Morocco and the people, the many historic sites to see, along with a game of golf, I think we have a winner for tourism for Morocco.
This considerable improvement is due to His Majesty late King Hassan II, who was a visionary. In 1971, His Majesty late King Hassan II inaugurated Royal Golf Dar es Salaam in Rabat and initiated the first Moroccan international competition. The Hassan II Golf Trophy was born. Its vocation is to attract the greatest champions. Unanimously, the Hassan II Golf Trophy gets much more than the other competitions. It is synonym of brotherhood and humanity.
I think if anyone comes to this country and they do not experience the cultural side of the country, they are missing something in their life.
The Lalah Merriam Golf Cup welcomed the biggest names of the ladies' world golf. Combining both tournaments in the same place, within the same week of competition, is a unique format in global golf history.
C'est la première fois au monde que le circuit masculin et le circuit féminin se jouent dans la même ville, dans la même semaine.
Mixing talents is the Hassan II Golf Trophy trademark. To maintain the uniqueness of the tournament, the Hassan II Golf Trophy Association wish to preserve a pro-am round open to amateur players, and among them, upcoming talented players. Every year, the number of tourist golfers increases. Morocco is a privileged golf destination. Soon, 300,000 tourists will come every year to discover Moroccan golf courses, generating more than 2 billion dirham income. The Hassan II Golf Trophy and the Lalah Merriam Golf Cup represent a real platform of exchange gathering. During each edition, international golf experts with various Moroccan golf actors to think about the issues to be taken into consideration in order to develop this sector following the example of the meeting days of tourism held in 2014. A year of revival. After more than a century of absence, the golf will be back during the Olympics Games of Rio. In Morocco, the Hassan II Golf Trophy Association, chaired by His Royal Highness Prince Moulay Rashid, is monitoring the development of a new generation of high-level golfers by organizing two key events, the Atlas Pro Tour and the Lalah Aisha Tour School. Access passes for Ladies European Tour, where Maha Hadioui, first Arab golfer to integrate the Ladies European Tour, becomes famous. Now more than ever in Morocco, golf generation is underway.